if someone was to ask me, you know, how do you feel about where hip hop is now as opposed to where it was when you were younger and what you thought of hip hop then? See, I came along in hip hop at a time when they said that hip hop had an expiration date. It was only going to last 10 years. It was a genre of music that was not taken seriously. And I'm going to tell you a short story about as far as how happy I am that hip hop is where it is today. They used to have this, what can I call it? There was this convention called Jack the Rapper. And being part of Jack the Rapper, they had this contest. And inside the contest was called the MC World Supremacy, which meant that you were the best in the world. And I remember my first year entering, first and only year entering. And they had it set up almost like the Final Four, but instead it just looked like it was everybody versus Roxanne Shanté, because it was just that time. You know, I didn't have a problem battling male or female. And so when I looked at the list of everyone who was going to battle for the entire day, it was like me versus Fuquan, me versus B, me versus Cool, me versus this, me versus... So I was saying to myself, like, oh, so nobody battles anybody else. Everybody battles me today. Okay, and I was fine with that, because being such a great freestyle artist, I was prepared for all that, especially since I knew that most of the artists that I was going up against had to write their rhymes, and I knew they weren't ready for that, so I was fine. So to make a long story short, we get down to the last two MCs. I've battled all day, voice almost gone, and it's myself and Busy B. I've been getting nines and tens all day. The judges were judges, of course, that you respect, your Grandmaster Cash, your Kumo D's, your Curtis Blows. These are artists that you respect. These are the greatest in the game, and these were also prior winners. Someone said in the crowd, well, you know, she's getting ready to be the best in the world. They're getting ready to crown a girl the best in the world, and she's only 15. She is going to be the best in the world. Wow, look at this. So now everybody's getting prepared for this. You know, we're getting ready to get the T-shirts done. We getting, you know, this is it. The best in the world is the girl for a change. And this was something that had only been going on for about 5 years. And they asked Curtis Blow, so in order for her to lose, this is what Curtis Blow said, in order for her to lose, what would it take? And they were like, man, she can't lose. The only way she can lose is if she gets like a 2. There's no way she can lose. She's been getting 9s and 10s all day. So he said, oh, okay. And then on his scorecard, he put the number 2. He took it, he turned it around, he raised it up, it was a 2. I looked, I seen it was a 2. They crowned Busy B the winner. Everybody was like, oh my God, how could you say that Busy B won? You know, she won. She really won. Like, he had to leave out another way. Everybody was all upset. Everybody was having a fit. That was the day that I officially fell out of love with hip hop, because I understood that hip hop wasn't what I thought it was. I thought, you know, in order to be the best, you must beat the best. This is what I've done. I'm that's it. This is what I came in here to be. I didn't come to be a great female MC. I came in here to be a great MC. There was no title female MC before me. That, you know, that's how they gave me a consolation prize. But you'll be the best girl ever. There will never be another. You are the best female MC. And that's not what I came into this genre for. I came in here because I wanted to be the best MC, period. And so years later on, actually, me and my husband bumped into Curtis Blow. And, you know, I've been blessed. Third most sampled voice. I do voiceovers for video games. You know, I'm okay. You know, I'm not one of those angry old school rappers. I'm good and very humble. So it doesn't make me, you know, I'm one of those people. Like, you say, okay, look, come on, we're going to go here. I'm like, all right, cool. Come on, let's go. You know, it doesn't have to be anything fancy for me. I'll eat at your mama's house. It don't make me a difference. I'm good. As long as the food is good and everybody's got a good vibe, I'm rolling with it. That's, you know, humble Roxanne Shanté. So we see Curtis Blow at an event, me and my husband. My husband says, babe, diggle Curtis. So I said, yes, babe. He's like, okay, look, he coming over here. I said, babe, okay. Now, my husband's a retired boxer. Not that he's confrontational, but, you know, he always wants to make sure everything is straight and everything is set straight. So I see Curtis walking over. So as I see Curtis walking over, he says, Shanté, can I talk to you for a minute? My husband, I said, yeah. So I said, yeah, Curtis was. He said, you know, God has been good to you. You have been so blessed. A lot of MCs have not made it where you've made it. And now, mind you, this is before the movie. We're not even talking about movie deals yet. We're just talking about, this is just regular life, you know, a few years ago when he said this to me. And he was like, you know, I just want to tell you how I felt that day. I just want to explain to you. So I told him, because I've been blessed and I have a great relationship with the universe, and not to mess that up, I didn't want to discuss it. I was like, oh, look, it's okay. I'm past it. Don't worry about it. That's when I was younger. I was a little girl, you know, that's it. And he was like, no, it's heavy on my heart. I need to explain. My husband was like, let him explain. You know, like, cause he wanted to hear. He was like, just let him explain. And I'm saying to myself, like, babe, just let the man go. He said, no, let him explain. He want to explain. Let the man get off his chest. I said, okay, let him get off his chest. Yes, Curtis, go ahead. What's wrong? He said, I just want to explain to you. And it's so funny because I talked to Curtis this morning because he called me up and said, thank you for not putting it in the movie. I said, okay, don't worry about it. I'll just put it in all the interviews. So he said, Shiny, because they call me Shiny. You know, if you are at a certain level in hip hop, you could call me Shiny. Up until that point, I'm Roxanne or Shanté, you know. So anyway, he says, that day you did win. My husband cuts in again. Told you you won. I told you. Babe, let the man finish, he said. But the genre of hip-hop was new. We were just starting to get major deals. The record companies were just starting to look at us like we were something. They were finally starting to... It was hard to get them to respect hip-hop with us being men coming out of the projects when they already said, this is no good type of genre of music because you guys aren't even musicians. You don't even play musical instruments. You take other people's beats, you sing over them, you make a lot of money, this doesn't make no sense, and you don't even have a singing voice. He said, and it was hard to get them to take us serious. And there was no way in the world that we could allow the best to be a 15-year-old girl at that time because hip-hop would have died and no one would have taken hip-hop serious if we went into these buildings or we went into these record companies or we went to these large promoters and these huge venues and said the best in the world is a 15-year-old girl. So that's the reason why I had to give you a 2 that day. Now I want to bring you to present day. I said I understood. I was okay with that. When people ask me how do I feel about hip-hop, I know that being self-sacrificing and taking that loss that day when I did not lose allowed hip hop to grow to the level that it is today, then I must say I'm very proud. Now, I'd be more hurt if it disappeared and I took that loss for nothing. But if I took that loss and it became a multi-billion dollar business because of that, then I'm okay with that. When I see other female MCs and they get these multi-million dollar deals, I'm okay with that. You know, when people say, well, they're doing award shows and Roxanne, they don't mention you or they don't talk about you from history. They try to start history from this point on. You know, they try not to include this or include that. I'm not angry. I'm okay with that. When new artists see me coming, and I'm talking like, and I've met my Cardis, my Nickies, you know, even our male rappers and, you know, our Kendricks and J. Cole's, when they see me come, they smile because why? I'm that happy aunt. I'm that aunt that shows up at the barbecue with a deck of cards, says, let's play spades, let's cook food, I'll let you stay up late, we're gonna hang out, you're gonna be okay. All I ask you to do is be respectful and make sure that you realize that you're representing me and always represent me properly. That's all I ask. That's all I ask for you to go, continue to be successful and make this bigger than anyone has ever seen. And they've done that. And I'm happy with that. And I'm good. So when people ask me questions like, well, you know, Roxanne, aren't you angry because this is the way it was? How could I be angry? How could I be angry? I have a record-breaking movie. Record-breaking. Contacted by Netflix. Record-breaking movie on Netflix. 33 years after only making 2 albums in a 30-some-odd year career. How could I be upset? You know, so when people ask me, how does Roxanne Shanté feel? I feel great.